One of the earliest roadblocks in the progression of abiotic factor is the commonly overlooked products of the now abandoned robotics program. This enemy type in particular is a real challenge when first starting out your playthrough, but usually becomes just another requisite on a long list of resources to gather. But in my opinion, this tiny slice of the lore and the unfortunate failure of the robotics program gives us a really good look at the true potential that the Gate conglomerate had prior to the Order's invasion and the many cogs working in the background, shadowed by the company's crown jewel of perforations. Let's talk about it. During the 80s at Cascade, amidst Gate's explosive growth across all fronts, a software engineer we have yet to meet named Dr. Stuart Wakeman sits across a terminally ill girl laid in a hospital bed, solemnly discussing something so ahead of its time it's almost comical. The idea of human consciousness uploaded into machinery and digital information. Facing an untimely death, Kylie agrees to Wakeman's trials and surrenders her body for experimentation. But to what end? Well, let's rewind back a bit. In 1985, after a certain decompression incident at the Torrey facility, Wakeman begins work on his robotics program. Given complete control of his research by the research director Dr. Mance, he begins work on sentient artificial intelligence and finds partial success with Dr. Alice Mayfield's security bot design. Although not exactly sentient artificial intelligence, it's an incredibly advanced technology for the time period. These robots sport electricity conducting clamps and are assigned to the lower security areas of the Cascade facility, recharging during the day and patrolling during the night. Security robots clean out internal threats as well as handling the restock of vending machines. An unfortunate flaw in the security robot and its later iterations is its inability to distinguish staff from real threats, needing scientists to sport a night pass to avoid being injured by patrolling robots. But flaws aside, this technology is an incredible leap into the future on its own. Even in real life, in modern times, the production of truly reliable autonomous robots is yet to be widespread. The applications for this kind of tech and its room for growth are truly endless, as Wakeman and his later adjustments to security bots is a testament to that, with the containment robot model. An especially important evolution to the security robot, the first immediately noticeable difference in the models is the introduction of armor plating on critical points like the shoulder joints and the knee joints, as well as a seemingly more durable alloy being used in its assembly. All of these upgrades in its design are compounded by the ability to run at a full sprint towards any escape targets, being able to grapple them with its other clamp arm and shattering a leg in the case of scientists, while escorting anything captured into nearby holding cells by force. These bad boys were deployed around the Cascade laboratories around critical areas, their charging stations marked with purple hazard tape. These automatons share the same critical flaw with their earlier models, being unable to differentiate escaped IS from everyday scientists. This push towards more offensive capabilities in the robotics program culminates into the unfortunately still prototype lethal defense robot model, their development interrupted by the game's events. A completely combat-oriented automaton, the majority of the prototype models produced are forcefully deployed for active field use during the ongoing Order invasion throughout the security and dam sector. Sporting even more incredibly durable plating and thicker armor on critical points, this model is a huge upgrade when it comes to just sheer fortitude. Its more tame electric clamps from older models is replaced with an entire arm cannon, capable of shooting explosive and incendiary munition payloads from both short and very large distances. An undoubtedly dangerous and powerful weapon, the nearly indestructible defense robots still have a major weakness that allowed Gate's adversaries to breach as far as they did into the dam sector. The inability to distinguish scientists from enemies shared with other earlier models definitely had an impact on their reliability, but their true weakness is the exposed power bank on the backside of the model. Even light damage is enough to cause the entire machine to explode, effectively bypassing its many defensive advantages, a flaw the Order definitely took advantage of during their arrival. By the time of the defense bot production, Wakeman's project had the need to facilitate a full robotics laboratory, built in the hydroplant dam's underbelly. All three robot models were being manufactured on a production line and being upgraded constantly, along with the introduction of Kylie, whose brain was now suspended in a machine and hooked up to sensors in the laboratory, awaiting Wakeman's promise. After the events of the game, the reservoir of waters flood the robotics laboratory, completely trashing and disabling the robotics production line and likely much of the equipment. Luckily, the waters did not reach Kylie's capsule, but much of the laboratory sensors were damaged and disabled, leaving her in the dark, where our scientists come in and find her, and finally fulfill her original role, and we transfer her consciousness successfully into her neural chip, allowing us to multiply experience gains slightly. And that's basically where the story of the robotics program ends for now. But with its true potential still in the air, I'd like to speculate on how big of an impact the robotics program could have had on the company as a whole, if the Order's invasion was delayed for a month, or 6 months, or even like 10 years. How far could Wakeman have progressed his artificial intelligence and eventually his sentient artificial intelligence? Well, where do I even begin? Putting aside the flawed artificial intelligence itself and assuming it's rectified and constantly improved, the robotics at play with even these early models are invaluable. With some tweaks to the software and a few model changes, a logistic infrastructure-oriented robot would have been an incredible boon to the company. Picture a half a ton robot like the ones we have in game easily picking up its own weight or even double, making construction or repairs easy with minimal human supervision. Or the logistical potential of resource gathering after perforation and antiverse technology became the norm, replacing bulky vehicle equipment and removing the human risk of handling radioactive or volatile materials. These logistical robots would have helped to avoid some of the major accidents in Cascade and Gate at large we experienced in real time during our playthroughs. For example, the huge mistake at the reservoir with IS-142, named reservoir growths after being dropped into the waters on accident and growing a large colony after, completely unbeknownst to scientists. Perhaps errors like these could have been curbed with reliable automatons under human supervision instead of direct human interaction. For the more containment-oriented models, there's a ton of company potential with these. The containment bots in the primitive state definitely aided with tons of loss prevention already, but what if they were improved further? Perhaps if the Wakeman team made a more bulky variant capable of moving or escorting mega specimen like the Composer and the Tarrasque hand in hand with gatekeepers, human loss and error could probably be cut down considerably. Or specialized units made for initial encroachment into newly discovered antiverses with less lethal weaponry to tag along with trans-recon research teams, and bolster defensive capabilities and maybe curb even more human loss, preventing cases like Kanon. Modular designs could maybe allow for easy production of specialized containment protocol models for use at Cascade. For example, replaceable X-ray lamps instead of the normal yellow and red lamps to keep X-ray sensitive anomalies at bay during critical breaches. Imagine the ability to mitigate something like the Reaper during the Order invasion and defend security with containment robot squads sporting X-ray and laser weaponry. Although this one is completely speculation, perhaps elusive and dangerous entities like Shadowhopper could have models with special algorithms implemented to learn behaviors and deal with these threats quicker and safer every time a breach occurs or new instance is discovered, overall keeping Cascade and the organization safer overall. And for the most monetary potential in the robotics program, it's easily the defense robots and militarized robotics in general. Had the Wakeman project been given the adequate time to develop its lethal robotic capabilities, Gate would have become a monetary and physical powerhouse. I talked about this more in my Keystone video, but Gate undoubtedly has ties with practically all major governments. Perhaps they purchase exclusive research data or new technology as a whole, but something every government is interested in no matter the size is power. And we know war profiteering has been around since the dawn of human conflict. Exchanging valuables for manpower, privatized technology, or outright selling weapons to military entities fighting for power has been ludicrous time and time again in history. We all know Tony Stark and his military branch in Stark Industries. He would develop and sell weapons of war, and it could have easily been no different for Gate. The already faulty defense robot models are basically impervious to small arms fire, and potent laser/electrical weapons require heavy sustained fire to take one down. Antiverse 2 entities like Alpha Peccaries and Armored Exors, two entities researchers at Cascade were working towards controlling by the way, undoubtedly for combat, are easily deleted by defense units. Making more variety models with conventional weaponry like machine guns or lasers to reduce collateral damage, which the current defense robots would definitely cause, would be a major selling point to any purchaser looking for weapons to add to their arsenal. With enough improvements, the Cascade Research Facility could have possibly ended up having a fleet of advanced artificial intelligence robots for any task by the turn of the century. With perforation technology up and running smoothly for easier logistics and military contracts coming in left and right for funding, imagine a robotics manufacturing sector or even a complete facility dedicated to printing out models. And all of this with just the artificial intelligence we see in game with some upgrades over time. If Wakeman had completed his sentient artificial intelligence goal, maybe not with Kylie and maybe not with many more subjects, but if he had in some reasonable time period reached his goal, the robotics program would have been a completely different Titan. And that's my views on the robotics program. I'm kind of disappointed everything in the lore points to the defense robots being the last we see of Wakeman's work on artificial intelligence, since the potential in the narrative would have been awesome to see being explored in the later stages, like maybe some super advanced robot in the Keystone facility, but I guess we have to take what we get. So let me know what you guys think of the robotics program or any other interesting small background lore. I also made some subtle and not so subtle changes to editing and other YouTube stuff and whatever, so let me know what you think about that. Anyways, I've been Myriad, your favorite yapper, and have a good day or night. Bye-bye.